Howdy! It's Levi again here with another installment of HPRC's video tutorial series. If you've been following the series, you've learned how to get an account and how to access the clusters, so the next step is actually using the clusters. In this video, we'll take a look at the basic commands you need to work a cluster from a terminal. Okay, so first let's log in. If you'd like some more info on how to do this, you can check out the last video in the series. Okay, so now we're on the cluster. Now this text only display might be a little bit confusing if this is your first time logging in or just using a terminal in general, so let's break it down. If you're familiar with logging into a Mac or Windows machine, then you know that the first thing that you usually see after you log in is your desktop. Now you should think of that desktop as just a folder, or directory, which contains files such as the icons for your programs. Now for our clusters, there's obviously no desktop, but you're put into what's called your home directory after you log in, and then you can put in commands to the cluster. Your home directory is entirely yours, however, another one of your directories, the Scratch directory, is probably better suited to your needs. Now the reason for that is shown here at the end of the message of the day. Since the cluster is shared between users, we allocate specific quotas to each user to make sure that they don't create too many files or take up too much space on the system. Once a directory reaches these limits, it could cause your operations to fail if they are requiring files to be written. So for both directories, you have two main quotas. Your disk usage limit, which is the amount of storage on the drive that you're taking up, and the file usage limit, which is the number of files that you're taking up. Now notice that the home directory only has 10 gigabyte disk usage limit and 10,000 file limit. The Scratch directory has a 1 terabyte disk usage limit and a 250,000 file limit. For this reason, we recommend storing the files that you need on your Scratch directory. There's also a third directory not listed here called tiered, which is best suited to storing your backups, as it cannot be accessed by jobs that are running. The reason it's not listed here is because it's only available on Ada, and currently I'm logged into the Terra cluster. So most jobs run on the cluster are outputting files to a specific directory. If you end up running large-scale simulations that generate a lot of files, your directory could easily fill up. So for the cases with proper justification, our staff members can expand your Scratch and tiered directory to accommodate your needs, but cannot expand the home directory. If you'd like to see your quota status at any time, you can use the show quota command. You can see that it returns /home/mynetid. This is called a file path. Notice the slash at the beginning. This means the directory's location is given relative to the highest tier of the file system. When a file or directory's location is written like this, it's called an absolute path. Another way to represent file locations is relative to where you are now, called a relative path. Another way to store paths is with environment variables. Now these are denoted with a dollar sign followed by all caps, and they just store a file path to make it easier to type or to be used as an argument for a script. To see what's inside of a directory, we can use the ls command. Many commands such as ls support options or flags, which are usually a dash followed by a character. In this case, we can use the -l flag to specify the long format of the ls output. Notice the difference from before. You can get an overview of any command's function and all of its possible flags by using the man command, which stands for manual, followed by the command you want to learn about. So here I've brought up the manual for ls. You can see it describes the basic function here, lists the flags here. Now if I want to exit out of this, I can just hit the Q key, which stands for quit. So let's say we'd like to use our Scratch directory to store some files. How do we actually get into it? Well, you can use the cd command, which stands for change directory, followed by the environment variable scratch. Now we can use the pwd command, print working directory, to show our location in the file system. Okay, now there's also a similar environment variable for the home directory. See here, we can do cd home. Print working directory again, and we're back in our home. So these are the basic commands that you need to get started with cluster use. But of course, there's a lot more to be learned about using the command line. For that reason, HPRC puts on training events called short courses most weeks of the semester. One of our larger short courses, Introduction to Linux, provides a larger overview of how to use the terminal. For more information, check out our website, hprc.tamu.edu, and use the Events tab to go to Short Courses. Here you can register to attend a short course, see our short course schedule, and even find slides from our previous courses if you'd like to learn on your own. You can also use this site's About tab to find contact info for our help desk. which can assist you with any HPRC-related questions or concerns.
You can also find a variety of Unix shell tutorials online. I highly recommend tutorialspoint.com.
As always, thanks for tuning in, and we'll see you on the next video.